Hello, everyone. I'm here with Sameer Rahman, who runs the data science practice at Kin and Carta's edit agency. And we're going to talk a little bit about data science today and the practical applications of data science within the customer experience. Sameer, maybe we can start and you can just give us a little bit of background on yourself.
Yeah, so I've been working in the data science industry for 17 years now. Started off as a risk analyst and then joined the Kin and Carta group 3 years ago, leading there and setting up the data science function.
Awesome. Maybe just as a baseline for everybody, because data science, I feel like, is one of those oft-used terms, and it's often used in different ways, and different folks have different understandings of what it is. So from your perspective, what is data science?
What is data science? It's a very good question. It's a question hard to answer. But it's essentially a multidisciplinary skill composed of three different elements. One is the technology element. So you have the data, you have to prepare the data for proper analysis. So you require some coding experience and technology experience. The second skill set is about the stats and the maths element. So you need to produce that insight from the data, and you require the statistical acumen to do that. So that's the second. And the third bit, which has always been missing from the traditional data analyst, is the business acumen and the commercial nous. So it's actually, once you have produced the insight from the data, how to use that insight and deploy the insight for commercial outcomes. So data science for me is a conglomeration of those three skills: technology, insight, and business acumen.
And you know, it's interesting to hear you talk about it that way, with those kind of three disciplines being necessary. I feel like the business acumen piece, because it's such a powerful set of technologies, but the understanding of how to apply that is almost the largest constraint that I see in the industry today.
Oh, absolutely. I think I read a report somewhere that 10% of the insight that you generate is being actually used in the proper way. In my previous last 17 years, I can absolutely guarantee that is the most important skill, because lots of insight is generated. Technology barriers, as you say, has been lowered and has been lowering every day. It's just what to do with the insight that you've produced. That is where the real role of the data science lies.
So there's practical applications of data science that expand to every industry: healthcare, biotech, energy. What I'd like to focus on today is the practical applications as it relates to the customer experience, because obviously that's the world that we live in. Yeah. If you think about that whole journey, maybe starting with acquisition, what are some practical applications of data science as it relates to customer acquisition?
I think the acquisition is a key part of where data science can influence, because sometimes consumers don't know what they actually need. So the prediction of that need is an important element of it. I mean, we've done lots of examples where identifying that need and then predicting that need and offering the customer with a relevant product and the price and at the right time when they are looking to be in the market. So just being that a bit ahead through our predictive modeling practices, which is part of data science.
And what does that actually look like? I mean, so are you running kind of A/B tests and just getting data from a sampling of folks and then using that to dictate a larger campaign spend or something along those lines?
Yeah, so we look at historical information for people who have not been in the market but who have responded to a particular offer or a particular proposition. We then find out patterns within that data, and then we translate that into people who might again be in the market. So it's all based on historical data, but it's based on data which is more recent, so you can predict from that. So from a practical application, if very much like Amazon style, if you bought something and people like you have bought something and you know their browsing behavior and all the other data, then you can predict with much more accuracy what their actual need is and when they will be in the market for that particular product.
And does that apply to a specific channel or across channels?
The information is there to be used across any channel. So it's pretty much, you can use it for one particular channel, you can use it for omni-channel marketing. Because what data science does, and it's important distinction, is it identifies a customer need. And that customer need can then be fulfilled through any channel.
So do you have any specific examples you could give of where you've seen this deployed successfully?
Yeah, lots of examples. So we ourselves have done lots of case studies for an insurance client, for example, where we help them bring new customers into their portfolio, identify a market gap which wasn't there, so predicted the need for a new product within a new market. And then as a result, they develop, they completely developed a new brand to cater to that market.
Interesting.
And it helped them gain market share. It helped them, I think, 5% of their revenue now within the last 18 months has been driven by that particular product.
So even in advance of trying to acquire the customer, just doing the analysis to determine where there may be some white space in the market, that's a great application.
Yeah.
How about from a savings perspective? I mean, a lot of the, I think there's a little bit of trepidation to invest in data science because obviously the skill sets are relatively expensive and the discipline takes a while to build. But is there a return there outside of outside of getting lift, which is the thing everyone's targeting? Is there additional forms of return?
Absolutely. I mean, it's all about, as we said, the whole definition of data science is about business acumen. It's about return of investment. And the way we justify the investment to the client is around how much return they'll get from a commercial basis. So again, case studies like a pure acquisition model or a response model that we develop to predict who will respond to a particular campaign. We have saved clients money in the range of $1 million per quarter purely by doing that kind of modeling. Mm. So there's lots of costs saving, but I think the way we need to see data science going forwards is it's an opportunity, it's an investment center rather than a cost center.
So as we move past the customer acquisition phase and the journey goes into the customer actually using the product or the service that they've purchased, assuming it has some digital component to it, how can data science be used to actually improve that product or service experience in real time?
Yeah, I mean, data science is, as I said, it identifies customer need at every stage. So it can be used across multiple industries, across multiple channels. We can use data science to predict for an agriculture client, for example, to predict crop yield, for a financial services client to predict investor portfolio and what features they would want to use and how the investment will blossom over time. Insurance examples, which other insurance they're more likely to buy and how to increase their lifetime value through upselling and cross-selling. And the real-time element, which we touched on rightly, is very much all that can be deployed digitally across the web content management platform. When customers on site, let's say for a travel client, which is another industry, which is a big user of data science, you go on, you know somebody's got a higher lifetime value, but they're looking to churn. You do something instantly because that's the point of engagement that you want to capture. And real time, your offers and your content changes for that particular customer.
So anywhere that you've got data that can help either model out for a customer how something could evolve over time or predict what that customer might do and then change the experience to influence the right behavior.
Yeah.
That's a place that we could use.
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, as I said at the start, data science is all about identifying customer need. And then once you've identified that, the execution platforms and the technology bit comes in. And that is where you can, once you've identified that, you can do whichever execution you want. So you can, in real time, you can communicate with them. You can give them another product feature. You can give them another offer. So it can be used quite universally across multitude of platforms and across multitude of media.
So when you kind of alluded to this, but as we move into the retention phase of the journey or the engagement phase, where have you seen value in terms of applying this?
I mean, the lifetime value is a big thing. I think we have done lots of studies on and work on lifetime value models where you identify people who are more likely to buy again or people who are more likely to buy another product from the same provider. But it's all about preempting that need and putting that idea in the consumer's head and that other product is the need and that is what they want. So we have seen lots of examples and done lots of cases with clients where lifetime value models have given them 8 times the value of what the first purchase has given them. And we try to change business mindsets in terms of making lifetime value the KPI for the business as well, rather than assessing campaign performance and the ROI based on one particular campaign or one particular media. It's more about how the consumer during their lifetime performs and which triggers are helpful to make them the consumer and the value that they are now.
And I would imagine that the data that you're collecting at kind of that latter phase of the journey can help influence your acquisition strategy in the beginning.
Yeah, absolutely. As I said, it's all about the whole journey and understanding of the consumer through the whole journey. Once you've done that and you've understood your customer and their journey, then you can apply it to the acquisition phase and the prospect phase, where you say, I know who this consumer are. There are works that we have done in the past where we have prospect lifetime value. So they haven't even become a customer, but because you've got that knowledge that they might become a customer, and once they become a customer, how they will behave. Mm-hmm. So exactly to your point, you can use that at an acquisition level as well.
That's fascinating, because what we see often is that these different phases of the customer journey are often owned by different parts of the organization. Mm. And so as an end customer, your experience is somewhat disjointed. Mm. And part of that's a creative problem, but I think part of it's a data problem and not kind of passing that data and that knowledge throughout the customer journey. So can data science be looked at as a red thread that can kind of make these experiences more meaningful for customers?
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, that is what data science is all about. What the reason that data science has, or the data analysts in the past, haven't done the whole customer experience is because data has already existed in a silo. So remember when I told you about the definition of data science and technology being a key part, what technology has now allowed is you can stitch all the data together rather than data sitting in silos of acquisition, retention, lifetime value. Once you stitch all that data together, then data science practices allow you to analyze that customer experience as a whole rather than different parts of the customer journey. The business acumen then helps you in the whole journey as to at different parts, how do you apply the business knowledge.
So one other question for you. There's a lot of talk out in the industry today about machine learning and artificial intelligence, and obviously data science is a component of that. But can you talk a little bit about how those things relate to one another?
Yeah, of course. I mean, data science is more of an umbrella term. So it's a catch-all phrase to define every bit of what you can do with the data, including data engineering, data quality, data processing, insight generation, and then the deployment of data. So it encapsulates everything. Before we come onto the machine learning bit, I think there's the old world of analysis was around the descriptive and the diagnostic element, which was around tell me what has happened, and tell me what is working, what isn't working.
So on the maturity curve, those are the first kind of phases of getting insight from data.
Yeah, so that was the typical maturity curve probably 10 years ago when the data analyst looked at those things, developed reports, developed campaign reports, post-campaign analysis to do that. Now, we slightly started migrating towards data science in the maturity model was when we started developing predictive models and off late more automated predictive models, which is where the real machine learning starts to take shape, and I'll describe about the machine learning. And then we move towards the more preemptive stuff, where we use data to transform businesses. Often quoted examples are Uber and Netflix, where they use data to develop a taxi business, or they use data for content generation. So when we come on to machine learning, I would always anecdotally describe it as how my son learns. I fed in the algorithm in him through my genes as to how he learns. He learns from his nursery teacher, he learns from the surroundings, from his peers, from everyday world that he sees. And that is an automated form of learning. So more ingestion of data goes into his brain, and he's learning and picking up words and everything as he goes. And that is essentially what machine learning is in a nutshell, in a very simplified example. And when we come on to the artificial intelligence bit, that's much more. Machine learning is a small part of artificial intelligence. Artificial intelligence has got a bigger remit. So it can be applied across various, it can be applied to save lives, it can be applied in agriculture for crop yield, it can be applied in the financial services for investor portfolio, and it can be applied for travel companies for personalization. So machine learning is a part of artificial intelligence, which is a part of the catch-all phrase that is going to be used, which is data science.
Fascinating, and I'm sure we can dig into that topic in a lot more detail in a future conversation. But I'd love to hear about your new book. So you recently published a book. Congratulations.
Yeah. Oh, thank you very much.
Tell us a little bit about it.
Yeah, the book has been coming along for the last 18 months. It's more around, as I described, the maturity model. It's more around the predictive, which is when machine learning starts to take shape and how to make a prediction, and then that prediction becomes an automated prediction. So the book more specifically deals with a very niche area of how to apply data science within direct marketing practices and how to improve the customer experience through direct marketing channels. So that's what the book is all about. It teaches you a step-by-step approach on how to develop predictive models and how to be an expert in predictive models, but more importantly, how to deploy those models, the business acumen piece again, to get the maximum return from the model that you've developed.
Excellent. And where could people find the book?
It's on Amazon, as every book is. We are trying to get it in university libraries and other places as well very soon.
Well, Sameer, congratulations again on the book.
Thank you very much.
A fascinating accomplishment. Thank you for sharing that knowledge with the world, and thank
Pleasure.
You for being part of the Connective.
I'm enjoying the Connective. There's miles to go before we sleep.
Yes.
Thanks, Jay.
Thanks, Sameer.
Thank you.